is in my Model X. Pretty little skinny little bitty body Model X. Some of y'all ain't never had no real and it shows. I keep it 100 from my head down to my toes. Back up on my bullshit, back up on the move. Touchdown in my hometown, got nothing to... Hey guys, it's Beauty by Ja and I'm here with another video. I'm super excited to make this video because I've gotten so many questions about my school, Columbia College Chicago. So today I decided to just answer some of you guys' questions. These are questions from Instagram, and my Instagram, I'll plug it right here, and also from past videos, and I'll link all of my college videos down below. I have a dorm tour, admitted students day, orientation, first week, all of that will be down below. So let's get started. So just for anyone who might be wondering, I go to Columbia College Chicago. I will be a sophomore this year, and my major was fashion studies first semester. Now I changed it to public relations. So I'll be talking about both kind of. Okay, so the first question that I got is Chicago as bad as people make it seem? So I really liked this question because I feel like people have this false thought about Chicago. Every city, state, country has its bad parts. Like, of course, it's things that happen everywhere, period. So the only thing I would suggest is to stay buddied up. Never go anywhere. Come close, listen. Never go anywhere by yourself, okay? Especially if you're a female. Like males too, but females especially. Never go anywhere by yourself. Always be with at least one other person, buddied up, okay? Especially not at night. Like, you might be able to get away with it in the morning, but especially not at night, okay? But yeah, stay out of the bad parts. Like, no offense, but like the West Side, South Side, those are pretty much the bad parts. So just stay close to campus, okay? You don't need to be going out far anyways. Stay close to campus. How is the BSU? So I really like this question as well because I love our BSU. We meet once a week, every Wednesday. I might upload a BSU vlog, BSU vlog. So keep on the lookout for that. I might, I don't know if I have enough footage, but I might. But BSU is really fun. We have all different types of meetings. We have meetings where we do games, where we win prizes. And then there's other meetings where it's really chill. We just have a genuine talk surrounded by all these Black people. It's so fun. It's so nice being surrounded by Black people. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. But yeah, the meetings, they differ each week. Some are more fun than others, I'm not gonna lie, but overall BSU is just a great environment, a great community, a great group of people, and it's all different types of people, all different types. It's even white people and Latinos that come to BSU, so, but it's majority Black, but it's a really good time, really lit, really fun, and they throw a party first semester. Then they throw like a ball type thing second semester, which I didn't get to do this year because obviously due to Miss Corona, we're at home, but hopefully I could vlog that next semester. Is there a free gym? Because I need to get my body right, period. Yes, there's a free gym. Every dorm has a free gym. And also the student center has a free gym. I would recommend the student center because the student center is top notch. It's up there, really nice. They have like the spin cycles, you know, the cycles where you go up and down and stuff. They have those. They have yoga classes. They have weights. They have all types of stuff. So I would definitely suggest the student center. But I know you're not gonna feel like going to the student center every day. So it's very handy to have the gyms at every dorm. So definitely utilize that because it's free, completely free. It's open 24 hours, I'm pretty sure. So yeah, you can go anytime. Really nice. What is your major and what are the classes like for your major? So like I said, first semester I was fashion studies. This semester I am public relations. And your classes, I mean, it depends on your major, honestly. Like for me, it's a lot of intro classes. Your first year, you're gonna have a lot of intro classes. Like intro to fashion, intro to public relations, intro to web design, things like that. Just to, you know, give you a little taste of, you know, the field and of the things that you're gonna have to do for your major. So yeah, it's, you know, obviously specified to your major. It's not too much. The workload isn't too much. And it's, yes, you're gonna be doing things that will help you for your career. How many students are in an average classroom? So it depends on what class it is. So if it's a regular class, like a major, minor, English type class, then you're gonna have like no more than 30. It's really gonna be like 15 to 20 people. But in my Big Chicago class, it was a good 100 people in there. Like literally the class that we had to meet in was an auditorium. That's how many people was in it. But I only saw that from or with the Big Chicago class, not any other classes. Your normal classes will be around 15 to 20 people. What are the best dorms? So in my opinion, the best dorm is 30 East. I only say that because it's the newest dorm and it's the nicest dorm. I've never lived there, but I've been inside and it's super duper 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 nice. Clean, updated, modern. And then they have like a sky deck lounge thingy where they have like fire pits and stuff like that. It's really, really nice. But that's only from appearance. I would just say try to do UC or 30 East. Because the UC is really nice, in my opinion, too. So UC, 30 East are my top two. Then the Dwight is like down there. Because the Dwight is not bad. It's just far away from all of your classes. Like, it's the farthest dorm. And it's going to take you like an extra 5 minutes to get there compared to if you live at 30 East or the UC. And you might say, oh, 5 minutes, that's not much. But when it's 0 degrees outside, that's a lot. So definitely aim for 30 East or the University Center. What type of dorm did you stay in? I personally stayed in the Dwight. I had a single apartment style dorm. So basically I had my own room, but I had to share the bathroom with two other girls. And then I had two other roommates. So I had four roommates in total. It was really nice, really expensive, but it was worth it. We had a kitchen, a living room area, and two bathrooms. Do you go to other schools for football games? I never did personally, but I know that you can. I probably will try to do that next semester. But I know surrounding schools like DePaul, I think UIC might have a football team. I'm not too sure, but I'm pretty sure DePaul and Robert Morris, I know has a football team. Yeah. So it's just surrounding schools like that where you can always go to their football games. And since we have free Ventra passes, it's really easy to just hop on a bus and go to a football game. How do you get scholarships? So there's two ways. You can either one, go on Columbia's website, and there should be a tab that says scholarships, and it has so many scholarships. You put your major and things like that, and it'll just bring up just a bunch of scholarships for you. Or two, you can email your advisor and you can just ask them if there's any scholarships that they can recommend to you or where you can get any scholarships. Just ask them to send you scholarships because that's what they're there for. They're there to help you. So definitely use them. They're a resource. Are there parties? I get this question a lot. And it's kind of complicated to answer, but I'm gonna try my best. So basically, there sometimes is parties in the dorms, okay? But it's 9 times out of 10 gonna be like a small little kickback, okay? And if it's like a full-blown party with loud music, then it's going to get shut down because the RAs do not be playing, okay? So the dorm parties are not the best. They don't be lasting. They be dry sometimes. So those are like down here. Then there are parties thrown by organizations that won't be in the dorms. They'll be at the student center. They'll be at 623. They'll just be at a Columbia building. And those are really fun. Those are up here. Like BSU, like I said, they throw a party each semester. And it was bussing, for real. It was lit, it was fun, it was bussing, it was all that. It was really fun. And I think the Latino Alliance threw like a Y2K party, which was so fun too. Had the throwbacks, it was so fun. So those type of parties are the fun ones. And then third, we have the parties thrown by surrounding schools. And that's like in the middle. And I put it in the middle because you have to travel like at least 20 minutes for those parties. And when it's late at night, you're really not trying to travel like that. But they be fun. Like UIC throw parties, DePaul just threw a party. And they're really fun, but the only downside is that you're gonna have to travel more in compared to if it was a party at Columbia. So that's the only downside. Would you recommend a meal plan? I would. Like, I didn't have a meal plan my freshman year, but now I wish I did, because you're not gonna feel like cooking every day. You're not, especially not after class, after work, after any activity that you have. You're not gonna feel like cooking all the time. So I would recommend a meal plan, but I would say get a partial, okay? Don't get a full meal plan off that, because you can always upgrade to a full. But if you have a full already and you downgrade to a partial, then I'm pretty sure they're not gonna give you your money back, okay? So start with a partial, because 9 times out of 10, you're not gonna use your full meal plan, because you're gonna have class, you're gonna be sleepy sometimes. It's gonna be times where you don't feel like going down to the cab. So I feel like most people don't use their full meal plan. So start with a partial, okay? I'm putting y'all on game. I'm putting y'all on game, so y'all better take notes, listen, okay? Start with a partial, because you can always upgrade to a full if you feel like you need one. If you feel like a partial isn't enough, upgrade to a full. But you'll save a lot more money if you start with a partial, okay? Start with a partial, that's all I gotta say, here. How is the cab? The calf is nice. I've been there. I didn't have a meal plan, but my friends used to swipe me in, because like I said, they didn't use it a lot. They didn't use it as much as they thought they would. So they would have enough swipes to get me in so I could eat free. And it was really nice. They have a full variety of food. Like if you're vegan, they got stuff for you. If you're vegetarian, they got stuff for you. If you were a meat lover, they got stuff for you. Pescatarian, they got stuff for you. They have everything, they have it all. It's really nice. How are the teachers and students there? Also the learning environment. The teachers, I only had one teacher that I didn't like, and it could have just been me, because I know it was some people who liked her, but I personally did not like her. But so far the teachers are decent. I would recommend downloading the app Rate My Professors. I'm gonna put it right here. Rate My Professors. Download that before you do your schedule, okay? Because that's gonna have almost every teacher on there. And I say almost because there's some teachers who are on there for some reason, but it's going to have their review, how many stars they got out of 5. It's going to have comments from past students. It's going to have the type of teaching they do. It's going to have how much the workload is. If they do tests, it's going to have all of that. It helped me so much. Helped me so much. So I definitely recommend that. It's one of the biggest things you need in college because it helps a lot. You don't want to get stuck with a dirty teacher. Not even dirty, just a bad teacher. You don't want to get stuck with a bad teacher. So download Rate My Professor. The students are nice. I mean, I haven't had a real problem with any students. I feel like just with everywhere, you're going to have people that you vibe with and people that you don't vibe with. So you just have to choose the people, you know, your little tribe, your little clan, your little clique, you know. And but for the most part, I can say that people at Columbia do not judge. That's one of the biggest things that I love about Columbia, is nobody judges, because there's so many different types of people, so many, I don't want to say weird people because they're not like weird, but so many different people, so many unique people, and nobody judges at all, and I love it so much. But yeah, the students, they're decent. How was the class experience at Columbia? It's cool. I mean, in your major classes, you're surrounded by your competitors, to be honest, because y'all all are there for the same major. Y'all all are trying to get that job. So you get to see some of your competitors. But it's cool to be surrounded by people that have the same interest in that aspect. For the most part, you know, you're in college. So for the most part, people are really there to learn. It's not all that goofing around like how it was in high school. Like, this is the real deal. People are here to learn. Sometimes you might have some upperclassmen in your classes. I know I did a few times. But yeah, the classes are really nice. The environment is really nice. How did you submit your portfolio? I didn't really have a portfolio. I just submitted some videos. But it was, I don't know. But basically, on your application, it'll ask if you have a portfolio to submit. So if you do, then you just submit it there. It'll be like a part of the portfolio where it'll ask you to submit your portfolio. I said that wrong. It'll be a part of the application where they'll ask you to submit your portfolio. When you applied, how long did it take them to accept you? It took a good week, I would say. Maybe not even that. At most, it was a week. I know I wasn't waiting long at all. It was a really quick process. They emailed me first. So expect an email first. Then they'll send your acceptance letter. Okay? Email first, then acceptance little package letter folder. What all do they ask for when applying? So this was kind of a long time ago when I applied, so I'm gonna try to remember everything, but I know they asked for, it was like 2 or 3 essays. It wasn't even essays, it was like little short questions. Like literally my responses were 2 sentences max, not even like 3 sentences max. So they're not essays, they're like little short questions. Then they asked for your transcripts, for your SAT or ACT scores, which let me give you the insight, because I just learned this year. So, and this is facts, okay? This isn't no assumption, this is facts. So they don't even go by your SAT score. Like, it doesn't matter if you got a freaking 480 on your SAT, they're not looking at that. They're mostly looking at your grades, of course, and also your portfolio. So a portfolio can be very important if you don't have really the SAT score or the grades. But one of the administration did tell me that they don't even look at ACT or SAT scores. Like, it's really not a big portion, or it's not gonna make or break if you get into Colombia. So for all those people out there who's stressing, worrying about your SAT score, it's okay. Like, I'm not saying do horrible and accept a horrible score. I'm not saying that. Still try your best. But I'm saying it's really not gonna affect whether or not you get into Colombia. Is it expensive to attend Colombia if you apply for FAFSA? These questions are kind of hard because expensive is different to all types of people. Your expensive could be cheap to other people. So I don't really know how to answer that question. I mean, FAFSA, of course, is going to help a ton. It helped me a ton. FAFSA paid for basically my tuition. So the only thing that I had to pay for out of pocket was my room and board. Not room and board, just my room. My dorm. That's the only thing I had to pay for. I don't want to drop numbers because it's my business, but it was, if you do the math, it was how much the dorm was. So expensive is different to all types of people. All I can say is that FAFSA is definitely going to help a ton. Definitely going to help you pay for everything. What day was the orientation? Orientation is going to be all different types of days. There's not one specific day for everyone. It depends on your major. They have different days for different majors. So it just depends on your major. What's the homework load like at Columbia? And are you able to still balance your personal life with your school life? Good question. So the workload is, in my opinion, it wasn't bad. But once again, it's different for everybody. Some people have a harder time with homework. But for me personally, the workload wasn't bad. Since you meet, like, in college, it's so much different than high school. I always say this to everybody. Like, in high school, you have to do homework that night because you're going to have the same classes the next day. But in college, you're going to have that class once a week. So you literally have a whole week to do your assignment. Except for English classes, because English classes you meet twice a week, but you still have like a good chunk of days to do whatever assignment, you know, that is due. So because of that, it was really easy to balance my social life and my school life. Because of course, just do your homework first. Always put your homework first, because once you get your homework done, everything done, then you have all the time to, you know, be sociable and be with your friends and out on the town. So just do your homework first. And it's really not a lot. It's really not. So that is all the questions that I got. If I didn't answer a question that you might have had, then make sure you leave it down below, because I definitely want to get to all you guys' questions. This is really passionate for me because I know when I was looking at videos about Colombia, I didn't really find any videos that answered my questions. So when I went to Colombia, I wanted to make sure that I made videos for you guys that answered all you guys' questions, because I know I had a lot of questions that didn't get answered until I went to school. So I definitely want to be here for you guys, for all the incoming freshmen, incoming people. Just if you have another question, leave it down below. My social medias will all be down below if you want to ask me questions there. All of my college videos will be down below. My hair company, Sowell Hair, if you want some bundles for a good price, will be down below. And yeah, thank you guys for watching so much. And I'll see you guys next week with another video. Bye.